Welcome to Bloomberg Law. I'm Lou Pakia. The nation's 20th largest law firm, New York-based Dewey & LaBeouf, has seen dozens of partners defect in recent months as the firm experiences a cash crunch. We're joined today by Above the Law's editor, David Latt, who has been covering the developments. David, welcome back. Thanks for coming back on the show.
Thanks for having me, Lee.
Of course. So the Dewey situation seems to be worsening almost daily. Catch us up on the latest.
Well, the latest is, I guess, more defections. You've seen in the past week or so about a dozen partners leave for Wilkie, another half dozen lawyers, I believe, in the insurance area departed. So you're seeing a steady departure of lawyers from the firm. In addition, the firm is restructuring its leadership. Stephen Davis, the current chair, is moving to London, and he's going to now be part of a five-partner team that is going to be overseeing the firm. This was in response to requests by lawyers for more hands-on, active management. So you've seen a management shakeup at the top, and you've seen some partner departures continuing.
And of course, there are a couple other things floating around out there. There's a cash crunch brought on by guaranteed compensation for recently hired lateral attorneys, missed compensation payments to partners and former partners at that. And they have plans to dismiss 5% of its lawyers and 6% of administrative staff. All told, where is this situation heading?
It's not clear right now. According to Dewey, according to their spokesperson, they're experiencing a temporary issue because of a collections issue. So they're saying that they have a lot of outstanding bills out there to clients, and that money is trickling in, as it often does. And if it came in all at once, they would be fine. But because it is taking time to make its way to the Dewey coffers, this is why they're experiencing this liquidity issue. They also were scheduled to be talking to their lenders, I think, sometime in April. And they've accelerated those talks, so they'll be talking to their banks a little bit earlier. So they are trying to find ways to get the cash all together to deal with their liquidity issues. But it's not clear, at least not to people in our position, where this is going. You hear rumors that the firm might owe $100 million to lenders, that it might owe tens of millions of dollars to partners. But we actually don't have the hard numbers of Dewey's book. So it's a little speculative to try and guess about what might be happening over there.
And of course, the firm claims that its problems are temporary, but departing partners are voting with their feet. Once this process starts to happen, you see partners moving towards the exit door. Is a firm inevitably sliding towards extinction, or is there a possibility that they can right the ship?
I would say it's an inevitable slide towards extinction. There have been some partners who, I think on background, have said that they were really reassured by the recent discussion that the partners had with management about firm finances. And one partner, again, not identified, but one partner who said that he was thinking of going elsewhere has decided to stick with Dewey for now. So there may be some people who are going to still remain with the firm. Also, some of those people who have the large guarantees, the recent arrivals at the firm, they may not want to leave because they're waiting for that deferred compensation to come in.
Sure.
So on the one hand, they might think, well, maybe I could get a better deal at some other firm. On the other hand, they might think, well, maybe I should just wait here for that money I've been expecting to finally arrive.
I don't want to leave it on the table. Dewey, of course, is the result of a 2007 merger between Dewey Ballantyne and LaBeouf Lamb. And it's also a firm where the highest compensated partners are compensated to the tune of 12 times as much as the lowest partners in the scheme. What roles, in your opinion, are merger dynamics and compensation inequity playing into this current situation?
Well, I think that they are really at the heart of this current situation because you had to bring in these partners with books of business by offering them very large guarantees. That squeezes the money available to other partners, including the partners who are servicing the clients. And so as a result, you end up with the system of the haves and the have-nots. And because the haves have so much guaranteed compensation coming to them, that reduces the amount available to pay other partners. It reduces the amount available to pay associates, whose bonuses are now being delayed sometime into May. They're usually paid out by April 1st. It reduces money available for staff, which is why you're also seeing about 6% of staff going to be reduced as part of this restructuring of the firm. So this chase for stars, which is the premise for this law firm growth, can actually sometimes be the undoing of a law firm.
Since 2008, most big firms have seen flat profits, and that's only after dramatic cuts in costs. 2012 is expected to be a make or break year for a lot of law firms. Which firms could be joining Dewey on this death watch list?
Oh, well, I don't think I'll go there, Lee. Firms are very sensitive about even being mentioned in the same breath as a story like that. People are, because it can become a self-fulfilling prophecy. If a firm is losing partners and people start wondering, is this a systemic larger problem, it becomes a self-reinforcing situation as other lawyers at the firm start looking for greener pastures. So I'm very loath to speculate on that because it comes across as reckless.
Right, but without naming names, to what extent are the problems faced by Dewey and LaBeouf industry-wide phenomenon? Is this something that it's not really particular just to one firm? It's really about all of big law?
I would say, I wouldn't say all of big law, but a good chunk of it. I think you could almost draw two camps. Mm-hmm. You can think of one camp of these firms that are the sort of old line, very established, largely New York-based firms with fairly lockstep compensation systems. And everybody is doing so well that they don't mind a lockstep system, even though some rainmakers are probably not getting paid as much at these firms as they could if they took their practice to a place like Dewey. And then you have firms like Dewey that are trying to expand by poaching rainmakers and practice group leaders from other firms. If you're going that second route, you're at the risk of being in a situation like Dewey, where you've made these guarantees to the people you poached and can't necessarily make all of your other payroll obligations. The firms that are in that first camp, the more traditional camp, the lockstep camp, they're not, to my knowledge, experiencing these kinds of issues. They're much more stable, and their finances and their payroll are much more stable, and their obligations to their current and former partners are much more stable. So I think that if you are going to see firms go down the Dewey route, they will be firms that have been very active in the lateral market, as opposed to these firms that tend to breed their partners homegrown.
Hmm. So bottom line for us, will Dewey be around in 6 months' time?
I think so. Maybe I'm being too much of a Pollyanna, but I think that the firm will weather this storm. But it, like you said, the situation changes from day to day, and so that prediction is not worth terribly much, but I think it'll be around.
All right, we'll have to see how it goes. David, thanks so much for coming in. Okay.
Thanks so much, Lee. It was a pleasure.
That's David Latt, editor of legal blog Above the Law. If you'd like to learn more about the issues we just discussed, be sure to check out our offerings on BloombergLaw.com. You can follow our updates on Twitter and see more of our videos on YouTube. I'm Lee Pacquia. Thanks for watching.